you think about the arc last year? Because it was crazy for you, in particular, your character.
What do I think about the arc?
Yeah, the whole...
Oh, the character arc?
Yes,
or the arc?
Your character's arc for the season. Let me start again.
No, I'm messing with you. My storyline last... Yeah, I liked it. You know, I really enjoyed working with Michael Beach a lot.
Yeah.
The Pike storyline. I thought that was kind of an interesting storyline, especially... People said, oh, that could never happen. Well, it's happening. It's happening now in America. So, you know, I thought that was cool that they intentionally, unintentionally, there was a parallel between that and politically what's happening now. For me, I really enjoyed my season last year. And that was, you know, I enjoy working with everyone, but I think that was largely working with Michael Beach. I had a lot of fun working with him. He was a good guy.
To have a character like him come in where you want to hate him so much, but you also understand where he's coming from, it's a new dynamic, which I really like.
Yeah. I didn't really understand where he was coming from, to be honest. This is more about you. But he was such a lovely guy. And you know what? He was so passionate about his character. And we would have chats about, you know, I'd say, you're Trump. And he'd go, no, but this is... he was fun. Yeah.
So did those type of conversations really go on, where you compared him to what's going on now politically?
Yeah. Lightheartedly, you know,
yeah.
We would mess with each other a lot, so that absolutely happened, yeah.
Interesting.
Well, what do you think we talk about?
No, I didn't.
How's my hair? How do I look? Hey, Michael.
You look gorgeous.
A week ago, the 100 Writers Club posted a pic of a mug that read World's Best Chancellor. Is that you again, or Abby, or who's going to be Chancellor now?
The Pike was the Chancellor, so that's a vacuum that needs to be filled. I don't even know who has that pin. That pin's been moved around so many times. I'm surprised it hasn't been lost. So that's something that needs to be filled, and that's kind of addressed in episode 1, season 4. So that, yeah. So there's a power vacuum that needs to be filled there, and also in Polis. There's no leader in Polis, so.
Yeah. How was it doing those more physical scenes in Gossip Polis, and you ended up having to take the chip? That was one of my favorite episodes, I think.
Oh.
How was doing all that stuff?
Being crucified, you mean?
Yeah, that.
I've done that before.
It's not,
that was easy. It was okay, you know. It wasn't that. The good thing about TV is we work fast.
Yeah.
You know, if that was a movie, I'd be up there for like days and weeks. On TV, it's like,
yeah,
we have to shoot now. Go, okay, get him off. Let's do the next scene. So it's not too long.
How is it playing that side of the character, kind of that inner struggle of whether you should take the chip or hoping Abby really didn't take it?
Yeah, I like that scene. That stuff was cool. It's always nice to. Our show is so plot driven. So doing a bit more character stuff is, you know, it's always, that's what we want as actors. We want that challenge.
Yeah. Are you surprised he's still alive at this
Kane?
Point? Yeah.
Yes and no. I have a contract. I have bills. And but yes. He has no real connection with anyone, you know. Like, you know, Abby has Clark, Jaha had Wells, and then the rest are all connected in some way. Kane was sort of floating free, and I think that's why I kind of latched onto the idea that Bob Bellamy could be my son. I needed a hook there, and now I've got Abby, so there's a connection. So, but yeah, he could have been. What was he doing? No. Yes.
Yeah.
He could have easily been killed a while ago.
I'm glad he hasn't been.
Sorry?
I'm glad he hasn't been killed.
Me too.